was my good fortune to lend a helping hand to the weary travelers flying from the land of bondage.
William Still was just a boy when he helped the first one escape. He never knew the man's name, only that he was being hunted by slave catchers. But in the years ahead, there would be many hundreds more. And Still vowed their stories would never be forgotten.
The heroism and desperate struggle that many of our people had to endure should be kept green in the memory of this and coming generations.
And he kept his promise. His diaries tell the secret stories of that great slave exodus known as the Underground Railroad. Impossible escapes, heartbreaking separations, and families reunited. William Still recorded it all, risking his own freedom to tell the stories of those who had the courage to run.
They were determined to have liberty, even at the cost of life.
Underground Railroad, the William Still story, is made possible by CN, built on strong foundations with roots in the early days of rail. CN serves Canada, the United States, and their markets with pride. CN, North America's railroad. And the Rogers Cable Network Fund. The Canada Media Fund. The Rogers Documentary Fund. With additional support from these funders. And by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, a private corporation funded by the American people and viewers like you.
William Still never forgot where he came from. The first generation of his family, born free. Raised in New Jersey, Still moves to Philadelphia at age 26 to work as a laborer. But he's ambitious, a man who taught himself to read and write and wants to do something with it.
He was organized, he was hardworking, he was a great communicator. I can use a lot of adjectives to describe him. Most of the good traits that we want in a great leader, he had them.
In the fall of 1847, Still applies for a job with the Pennsylvania Anti-Slavery Society. He starts as a clerk, but he has eyes on something much bigger.
Perhaps it may be the means of more than rewarding me in some future days. I go for liberty and improvement.
His duties involve the publicly stated business of the society, correspondence, record keeping, and the publication of an abolitionist newspaper called the Pennsylvania Freeman. But Still knows its secret purpose is the running of a covert resistance network dedicated to helping slaves escape from the South. It's a revolutionary cause.
The Underground Railroad was a mass movement of civil disobedience, and it was the first mass movement in American history when huge numbers of American people made sacrifices for other people's human rights. That never happened before.
But what they're up against is an institution with more than two centuries of history in America. In the southern states, slavery grows deeper roots every year.
By 1860, the dollar value of America's slaves, there were about 4 million slaves by 1860, but the dollar value of those slaves were greater than the dollar value of all of America's banks, all of America's railroads, all of America's manufacturing combined.